Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel and welcome to another video. This is part two of making the fire basket, so we'll just be carrying on as it ended on the last video. So we'll be forging out the legs on the fire basket frame, I do believe. Saying that, let's get straight into the video. Continue flattening this out on the corner. Squam on the end there, but I'm just going to bend this forward and back up just so it's a little bit more central and gives it a little bit of aesthetics. Probably as I tell, I'm just going to bend it, we're almost like a nice shape, turning tool. Right, so we've finished forging the legs out. So now we need to make the frame. So we've got some more 3/4 inch square steel, 19 inches from there to a mark there. We're going to get 8 of these. So we're going to have one around the base and then a decorative rim a little bit higher up. One around the base is going to just be underneath here. And then we're going to have some more angled cuts underneath it to support the tray. It should all weld nicely onto the legs. So let's get to it. Right, so everything's now oiled up. Nice and strong. And the tray is going to be resting on this bottom rim here. So what I'm going to do, place this underneath. And now I can make those lines a little bit clearer. And then we can cut with the end grinder. We're going to do that on each corner. The problem is, when you pull it out, it does make an awful noise. So what I'm going to do is, these are the nice edges, so I'll use that as the front and back, and I'm going to put a bar across the middle, just one, and that should hopefully, from both sides, make it a little bit easier to lift out. Again, we're going to use some more 3/4 inch. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Just finished. Yes, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And I hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you in the next one. Thank you very much. Bye bye.